Behold, the world's largest cow.
Jon's Adventure Vlog presents the Halfmerica Road Trip.
Hello and welcome to Jon's Adventure Vlog. My name is Jonathan Paula. As our Halfmerica 8,000-mile road trip continues, woke up in Bismarck today and we're heading west on I-94. And we saw this on the side of the road and absolutely had to make a stop.
We've come here to the top of a mountain in the middle of nowhere, New Salem, North Dakota to be specific, to see Salem Sue.
The world's largest Holstein cow is 38 feet high, 50 feet long, and weighs 12,000 pounds, erected at a cost of $40,000 in 1974, named after the Holsteins of New Salem High. Impressive. Most impressive.
That's a big set of teats. Well, there you go. Salem Sue, world's largest cow, overlooking the Great Plains of the Midwest. This is a big cow right here.
We now find ourselves in Medora, North Dakota, at the Chateau de Mores historical site up on the mountain.
It was clear to many that the call, "Go West, young man, go West," meant there were fortunes to be made. And soon the Gilded Age was on. Take a tour through the 26-room hunting cabin built by the Marquis de Mores in 1883 as a summertime residence for he and his wife, Medora.
It was here in the 1880s where a French nobleman basically founded the town by opening a meatpacking plant right off the railroad here. And this chateau was basically a summer cottage on the hill, and we're about to go explore it, check it out. And I have to say, now that we're out of the prairie lands and into the mountains and the badlands, this place is beautiful.
The china's pretty.
And according to our tour guide, 80 to 90% of it is all original.
Now, I have to imagine it was probably tough to sleep in a house, you know, without air conditioning, without heat, and also with railings and all those bedrooms. This place reminds me a lot of the Castle in the Clouds at Lake Winnipesaukee. Kind of a rich, hoity-toity, turn of the century, very fancy. Really well kept up. You can move in tomorrow night, you'd be all set. What's intriguing about the Marquis story, like 4 years later, he completely failed. The meatpacking thing did not work out. He moved back to France. Then he tried to open up a railway in Vietnam. That didn't work out. Then he moved to Africa, again, for a business venture. Very ambitious fella. And unfortunately, when he was in Africa, he was stabbed to death by his guides. Kind of a life of ambitious failure.
It's like prime writing material for like a soap opera or something. They both had fascinating lives.
Yeah, they both spoke multiple languages. They had kids that never reproduced.
He was apparently an accomplished dueler and had killed several men in what were then still legal duels.
But he killed someone here and he was on trial for it.
But he got away with it, just like George Zimmerman. The system works.
Something else I learned in our little half-hour tour are these vents here above the outside windows.
The reason for those vents is so the men could be out smoking cigars and drinking brandy, while the women kept to themselves with the shades closed inside. Fascinating little architectural design I've never seen in an old house before. But these guys were rich, fancy French noblemen, so they do what they want. That reminds me, the Marquis guy was also an anti-Semite. He blamed Jews for all of his business failures, and I thought that's hilarious. I got stabbed in Africa. Those Jews.
Unfortunately, that will have to do it for this episode of Jon's Adventure Vlog, but stay tuned for the next installment of my Halfmerica road trip, where we head to the North Dakota Badlands, just across the street here from the chateau at Theodore Roosevelt National Park. Until then, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.